Welcome to 42nd edition of Pod Universal, India's first pod magazine, brought to you by Prime Point Foundation. I am K. Srinivasan, editor of Pod Universal. Listeners may recall the controversy over the Ram Setu issue. There is a general belief amongst the Hindus that Nala Setu, or popularly known as Ram Setu, was constructed by Lord Ram in the Indian Ocean to connect India and Sri Lanka. There is also a strong belief that Hanuman and his Vanaraseva brought some unique floating stones from different places and used them for constructing this bridge. Recently, we came across two such stones weighing around 2.5 kg and 1.5 kg brought from Rameshwaram and picked up from the Ram Setu. We requested Dr. Kalyanaraman, an eminent researcher, to explain this phenomenon. Please listen to him now.
In Valmiki Ramayana, very detailed description of the Setu Bandha is given in the Yuddhakanda. It's almost like a bridge engineering manual. Nala organized this Vanarasena for bringing in material for building the causeway. Materials included trees, boughs, and boulders, which look like mountains and peaks. And the rocks created tumultuous sound as they were thrown into the sea, and when the mountains were falling into the ocean. The detailed description of the nature of the stone used is given in Tulsidas Ramayana and in many Puranas, including the Skanda Purana, which specifically mentions the nature of the stones that were used. The characteristic feature of the stone is that it floats in water, and that is described. And with great veneration, Rama is remembered as the person who made this Setu, called Nala Setu or Rama Setu, possible. From a scientific and geological perspective, the nature of the floating stone has been clearly established. The stones are accumulations or assemblies of coral groups or coral families, coral assemblies they were called. The almost like fossils, they cluster together. The characteristic nature of the corals is that they can be formed only on hard surface. They can't be formed on loose sand. When the investigations were done by geologist Dr. Badri Narayanan of the National Institute of Ocean Technology in relation to this Setu Samudram Channel project by digging bore wells, an astonishing scientific fact was discovered. On top, there were layers of sand shoals. And below, about 3 meters below these sand shoals, they found a layer of coral rocks. And below those layers of coral rocks were found layers of sand. So coral rocks could not have occurred in these layers of sand. So it's very clearly established that they were brought from the shore, either from the Rameshwaram side of the island or Thaimanna side of the bridge from Sri Lanka, and brought and placed here. Because below this layer of coral rock, again there is a layer of sand, below which there was hard rock formation. So this unusual formation in the middle of the ocean, for a distance of 35 kilometers from Dhanushkodi to Thalaimannar, would not have been formed by the ocean, because ocean does not form these blocks of rocks. So the rocks, which are of the nature of these coral rocks, which float on water, as you can see from the samples, is a clear indication of an intervention group of people who were able to bring these light stones from the shores to create the causeway on top of the ridge formation. So that's the, now we are having a very interesting phenomenon of science validating some very specific geological facts mentioned in our ancient texts, starting from Valmiki Ramayana, Ramacharitamanas of Tulsidas, which is the Hindi version of the Ramayana written in the 16th century. So for these hundreds and thousands of years, the tradition has been continuing, and stones like these have been revered as related to the contribution made by Sri Rama for us to remember these great piece of engineering marvel that has been created, Balarama.
Thank you, listeners. That was Dr. Kalyanaraman, an eminent researcher, explaining about the unique floating stone used in Ram Setu. Hope you enjoyed this part show. For updates, please log on to poduniversal.com. Please send in your comments and suggestions to editor@poduniversal.com. This is K. Srinivasan, editor of Pod Universal, signing off from the show. Till we meet next, bye and take care.